Well, the key is to focus more on entrepreneurship. And the story of America really is the story of entrepreneurship. That's why we're the leading economy. Great companies and great industries started here. So we really need to double down on our nation's entrepreneurs. And we outlined when we met with the president a whole framework, including some things administration needs to do, some things the private sector needs to do, but also some things that really need bipartisan support in Congress to make sure we have the right framework in place to help companies get started and help them scale. That's the big job creator. The Kauffman Foundation data says 40 million jobs have been created in the last 30 years from these high-growth entrepreneurial companies. It really counts for all the net job creation. So if you want to focus on jobs, you want to focus on the economy, you got to focus on entrepreneurship.
So when you say in the last three decades, you know, about 40 million jobs have been created by young firms, how does the White House or government as a whole try to open up those opportunities for that kind of entrepreneurial venture that you're talking about? Because a lot of people feel like, you know what, I need money in order to make money or start that business.
And that's part of our recommendation in terms of what we said Congress needs to do in a bipartisan way is a number of things to make it easier for companies to raise capital, both at the early stage with crowdfunding of angel investments, create some incentives, lower capital gains for early stage investments, make it easier for companies to go public. 90% of jobs are created after companies go public, but the Sarbanes-Oxley regime has made it more costly so fewer companies go public or they go public later. As a result, many companies also get sold, and we lose some of that acceleration in terms of job creation. And we also talked about the need to take a fresh look at immigration, particularly around high-skilled workers. We know immigration is a complicated, sensitive issue, but the reality is high-skilled workers, engineers, and entrepreneurs, we want them to stay here and create companies here. Right now, we educate them here at some of our great universities, give them a PhD in computer science, say, and then kick them out of the country and force them to go to other countries to start companies that compete with us. And that's crazy. So we need to unbundle this high-skilled worker piece from this broader discussion around immigration and get that done, too. If we focus on that and win the global battle of talent, we focus on capital access, we make it easier for companies to go public. Those are things Congress can do right now if they really focus in a bipartisan way. In addition, the administration, we outlined seven things they need to do, four things the private sector needs to do. There's no silver bullet. There's nothing magic about this. It really requires a comprehensive effort from all sectors.